Good morning.
Good morning.
My voice isn't great now, so I'm just going to talk about this for a while. It's lovely out there this morning. It was lovely and sunny right now, but it was foggy earlier.
It's gorgeous. It's still a bit foggy in some places, but yeah, I presume that's set to lift shortly.
Yeah, what I don't get is people who I came in a while ago and it wasn't sunny at all. It was really thick fog. And there was just people emerging out of the fog with no lights on.
I know, it's really like dangerous. Idiots. Sorry, I don't mean to laugh, but yeah, but people are idiotic.
Idiotic, yeah. But yeah. It will lift this morning, Elaine's right, and it's going to be actually a lovely morning. I think we're going to get a little bit of cloud cover into the afternoon, but dry today. Temperatures again around 21, 22, but we'll certainly see a sunny morning. And even now, you can probably see the sun is coming in on top of us here. It's not bad out there, in fairness. So, not a bad morning.
We've got a busy show on the way. Andrew, I was off, then I was back, and Andrew's off, so we're back together for the first time in a while this morning on the show. So we've loads to do. We've got a brand new Who's for Breakfast, which started yesterday. So if you missed that, we're on to day two. Nobody won yesterday, and we'll add €10 to the prize, and that means today it's worth €60. So tune in for a brand new mystery voice. Some of the big stories in the papers today: Irish Examiner front page. This is a very worrying story. The chief executive of the Dublin Rape Crisis Centre, Nolene Blackwell, says that Ireland is in the grip of a sexual violence epidemic, and Nolene thinks that we should open up new type of conversation around issues like consent and pornography. And this came as figures from its latest annual report reveal that in 3/4 of cases involving adults, the perpetrator was known to the victim. So very sad story in the front page of the Examiner. Santina Cawley, the death of the beautiful little girl in Cork, also on the front page of the Examiner. The heartbroken mother of Santina has said, "What animal could do that to a 2-year-old baby?" That's also on the front page of today's Irish Examiner today.
The Sun says, 7 deadly sinners, Kinnahan hits squad busted. And there's pictures of all the lads who were arrested in the last 24 hours by An Garda Síochána. There's also the shock death of Fair City's Carol on the front page this morning as well. And there's pictures of Brendan Grace's funeral from yesterday, where Brendan O'Carroll and his wife were there, Dickie Rock, Daniel O'Donnell, and Green Isle as Irish rugby hunk enters the villa.
I saw him this morning on Insta. He's a very good looking guy, actually. Sure, he'll get on well. He's from Limerick. He's a rugby player. I think his name is Greg.
He's an Irish rugby sevens player, yeah.
Irish Examiner. Actually, I want to go back to it for a second because I meant to mention this gorgeous photograph by Valerie O'Sullivan on the front page of the Examiner. And it's of Pat McGillicuddy and his son Timmy. And they're farriers, blacksmiths. And fantastic photo pictured. It's like going back in time. But they're at the family's forge in Killarney. And they'll celebrate the family's 50th anniversary as blacksmiths at the summer meeting at Killarney Racecourse, which I think Joe McGill was talking about that on the Saturday Supplement as well last week, I think. So lovely photo there by Valerie. And the Irish Daily Mail front page, families battered by a rip-off of school uniforms, is a headline in the Irish Daily Mail. Families are once again being hit with crippling increases in the cost of school uniforms, the survey has shown. Now, I have to step in and say that she's going into third now, but when she started in junior infants, she's got one of the uniforms that has the crest on it. Mm-hmm. So you kind of have to buy it from those new couple of places you can get it. And it's much more expensive than buying a little cheapy pinafore in one of the supermarkets. And I did kind of throw my eyes to heaven and think, oh, for God's sake, it's 3-4 times the price. Well, it lasted more than 3-4 times the time that the other stuff lasts.
Yes.
I think before people start to...
It's an investment.
Yeah, it is. It's obviously an expensive outlay of money. Mm. It's 30, 35 euro as opposed to maybe 9 euro or something. And because she has the other cheapy bits of other bits, like a little pants or the shirts and all the rest. And I could sometimes get them at the very cheap prices and they just don't last. And you end up buying 4 of them for one of the other ones.
Anyway.
And I actually think it's worse. I think you do end up replacing them more times. So anyway, I know it's very expensive. I'm not saying it's not, but I would say hold your breath if you're just starting school this year. The good uniforms do last way longer than the other ones.
It's actually all about schools in the Irish Independent this morning, in that it says class is now second most overcrowded in Europe. Irish primary school pupils are being educated in some of the most crowded classrooms in the entire EU. And stretched parents are forced to deny children school items as costs rise. So on the back of that uniform cost, it's now getting a child ready for secondary school costs an average of €1,400 a year, up €20 on last year. That's on the front page of the Irish Independent there this morning, where they say that they carried out this survey with the League of Irish Credit Unions because a lot of people are having to go and get loans in order to get their child sorted for school and so on. So more details in the Irish Independent this morning.
Some of the top trends that you're waking up to today. Katie Taylor is trending, and that's because the film about her was on RTE last night. I still haven't seen it. Have you seen it?
No, never watched it. No.
Yeah, I'd love to see it actually. So a lot of people talking about that on Twitter this morning. And Owen Morgan as well, another sporting story. After the England Cricket World Cup win at the weekend, a lot of people talking about the Irishman on Twitter today as well.
Love Island is trending. So Joanna's gone. Michael didn't go with Joanna, so there's war over that, because like he was just after proclaiming his love for her and everything else, and now everybody's like, oh my god, they're really upset. But 2 weeks apart's not really helping them. I'm sure, like, in fairness, like. And then you've got a third Irish person got in, as we mentioned, Greg from Limerick, who's an Irish rugby sevens player. Went into the Villa last night, so we haven't actually seen him on TV yet, but he went in there last night, and we'll find out what his crack is later tonight, 9 o'clock, Virgin Media 2.
I've also seen that the sales of false eyelashes have surged since Love Island returned to our screens. So yeah. Good, and bikinis.
And Fabian Delph is trending this morning as well. He has just signed for Everton from Man City. So that was another big story that broke there. I won't say overnight because it happened very late yesterday evening. But yeah, that's the latest from the Premier League.
We have got a lovely competition running all this week. It's giving you a chance of winning a family pass to go along to Bunratty Castle and Folk Park. Have you been there, Andy?
Never been, no.
Do you know, I was talking about it yesterday on the show. I was there years ago when I was a child and I loved it. It's fab. I've been there a couple of times, actually. We brought American cousins and things like that. And I bored the listeners twice. I mentioned it twice, I think, yesterday, that I made a little list at the start of the summer of things I really want to do this summer. And I'm good. I'm working my way through it. And Bunratty's on it.
Good.
So it's a really nice day out. And they've also got like a playground and a petting farm and all the rest.
Yeah,
they've got loads of stuff there. So we've got that competition as well coming up on the show, as well as Who's for Breakfast. And that's worth 60 quid today.
Yeah, that's about it from us for this morning. Now we're going to go live on the radio, so join us in a couple of minutes' time and enjoy your Tuesday.
Bye, guys.
Good luck.
Talk to you soon.